guys, welcome to NetHunt. Today we're gonna talk about customization as it is the core point when it comes to friendly usability of the product. NetHunt allows you to customize pretty much everything you're about to use in the system. When you start using the CRM, a few folders are already pre-set up for you. Companies, deals, contacts, tasks. NetHunt allows to adjust them all to your needs, meaning you can either delete them or rename them or change their structure. Also, you can import data into the existing folders. Even if you have different fields in your CSV file, you will be able to create and adjust fields on the go. By the way, you can move around the widgets on the dashboard as you like. It will be visible only on your account and won't affect other workspace users. Let's get to the folders. As you can see, they have different icons and colors you can customize. Simply go to the Customize folder and pick a color and an icon. Next, you will switch to the fields. Each folder has its structure. The fields you can see here. If you come from the spreadsheets, they are your columns. You can remove the fields, edit them, add new fields, reorder them. Moreover, you can group the fields simply by adding a new group and dragging the fields into it. You can also set the default values for each field, so once you create a new field, you will have certain ones pre-filled automatically. Let's make the stage field new by default. And the close date will be filled out plus 1 week from the creation date. You can specify the date range. For me, it's 1 week to close the deal. Saving the changes. Now, when I create a new record, I see the pre-filled values already. And you can go on and fill out other information. Remember we had the field groups? Now you can hide a few so they will not distract you while working on the deal. You just might have many fields, not like me in this case. By the way, when on the record, you can quickly go to the folder settings by clicking over here. Pretty fast, huh? Now, when all the folders are set, you can create views, which are the saved filters to get a fast access to the filtered data. Let's build a pipeline, meaning I need to group all the records by the field stage. The grouped view divides records into columns. I also can hide the column lost, so it doesn't disappoint me. Show some data on the deal cards. And summarize by the deal size, so I clearly see how much each funnel brings me. Now I get a beautiful card view. I need to save and make it visible to all the users having access to this folder. It will be available on the left sidebar under the folder or over here. If you do not want this view to be shown on the left sidebar, simply hide it from navigation provided you have lots of views created. The same you can do with the folders. Hide them from the left sidebar. They will be available on the dashboard. You can also create a specific view for yourself only to check the won deals for the past month. Let's group all of the deals by manager and add a filter for the close date, that is last month, and the stage should be 1. Plus, I want to see the profit my managers brought me. I summarize by the deal amount, and here you go. I save this view for myself only, and I can get back to it later. By the way, you can make it a default view for the folder, because now, when you open the folder, you always see the same record list. If you want to see a view by clicking on the folder, open the views over here and click on the house icon next to the view you want to make default. Now, every time you click on the folder, you will see the view you've chosen. It will be default for you only, not the whole team. Let's go to the inbox. Here you see the emails linked to certain records, and they show some info record related. On this one, I see the labels with the contact full name. These are the record snippets to show on the email labels. Also, you can make some quick actions from your inbox. Hover your mouse over to the record snippet. Mainly it is a contact record, where you can either call, go to a Facebook page, send an email, etc. It actually speeds your work. Moreover, if you have emails linked to several records from different folders, like I have here, you can hide certain ones from threads. They will not be deleted, just hidden, and you can check them by clicking on the plus sign. To go further with the record snippets, labels on the emails, they're set up in the folder settings. You see that I have a few fields to show, first and last name. And I can choose the title to be depicted on the snippet. I simply bookmark it and save the settings. Now, if I go to the inbox, I can already see the title showing on the label. Now let's move to another important part in the CRM, which are the user roles. Each of your coworker will be a part of the role with certain permissions. That's my team. In the settings, I see which role they belong to: admin, manager, and read-only. Each role has certain permissions. The admin role is the omnipotent one, having access to everything in the workspace. My managers only see a few folders here, and I have different access. Like, they can only see their records in the deals folder, they cannot export records. So when you invite a new user, decide which role to assign to them. In case a new user needs to have a unique set of permissions, create a role solely for them with the permissions needed. Also, there is a billing-only role, meaning that the user that is invited there has no access to the workspace data, but can only attach their card to pay for the subscription. This user will see the payment history and also change the subscription plan and update the card details. Let's now go through a few basic settings in NetHunt. There's a tab Preferences, allowing you to choose a system language, a date format, notifications you'd like to receive, follow-ups usage, email click tracking, and location on the workspace in Gmail, before or after the inbox. The import data feature allows to grab the data from other sources and put it into NetHunt. Syncing your Google contacts with NetHunt contacts. Getting the API key of your workspace over here if you need to integrate NetHunt with another tool. In the trash bin, recover the deleted folders, records, and fields. The deleted items will be available to restore for 30 days. The account management gives you permission to remove the account completely, only your user, and to erase all the data related to your Gmail or G Suite account. The workspace stays intact in case you are not the admin or not the only one user. In the workspace management, available only to the admin role, you can rename the workspace, exclude some email from the auto-linking, meaning that emails received from the listed addresses won't be automatically linked to the records they are mentioned in. You can later link such emails manually if needed. It's useful if you are a CEO of the company and do not want your emails with clients or partners to be linked as you discuss some secret information. In this section, you can also delete the workspace. These were a few tips on customizing your workspace, and you can get more info from other videos and articles. If you need more tips, feel free to email us at support@nethunt.com.